However, if you want to add kind of a second level of lighting and really highlight these beds, what I like doing is just with some Path and Garden lights like these guys, is using those to offset the balance of the uplighting by kind of positioning those, for example, in the middle of where you have those. So if you have an uplight here, you might throw a Path and Garden light in here. You have an uplight here, you throw a Path and Garden light somewhere in here. You have your uplight here, and then so on and so on. And you can have a couple of those Path and Garden lights that help highlight the beds a little bit, but then it'll also work well with around the front of the house.
Hey guys, it's Cal from The Lighting Doctor here. I hope you guys enjoy this video with some more great landscape lighting tips. To learn more about landscape lighting, go and check out our website at lightingdoctor.ca. Or if you want to see what a real quality landscape light should look like, go and check out our Try It Before You Buy It offer, where you can get a premium quality fixture at a discounted rate with your very own battery pack, so you can go and test out how that light's going to look and feel what a real premium quality light should look like. So go and check us out at lightingdoctor.ca, or go watch more videos on YouTube just by searching for The Lighting Doctor.
Hey, Kent, thanks for your email and for your pictures. Great house for landscape lighting. It's perfect. I'll show you some examples, some things you could really do to make it pop. But I'll just kind of give you an example of couple of the things I'll talk about. One is just the front columns and the porch area that you have is perfect. And you can really make some things look nice, as well as I'll talk a little bit about just the second story lighting and how we accomplish that using a simple tool and accessory like this called a gutter mount. But if this was a project that we were doing, the first thing I would do is I would really focus on just using a series of uplights and then some Path and Garden lights. And the uplights really to do, like I just showed in that front picture, is to really highlight the porch and these front columns. I would have one of those uplights pretty much at the base of every one of these kind of columns at the porch that's shining fairly close but shining straight up. That highlights that. It's going to highlight a little bit of the porch, and then that light kind of hits the top here. It's almost like you have some very subtle soffit lighting in there. And I would use one of those on pretty much every one of these columns that you have on the front porch here, including, you know, one here and then one in the corner as well. So call it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of those 10 of those uplights that do a really nice job of lighting the porch, and it'll give you some nice reflective light back down in the beds. However, if you want to add kind of a second level of lighting and really highlight these beds, what I like doing is just with some Path and Garden lights like these guys, is using those to offset the balance of the uplighting by kind of positioning those, for example, in the middle of where you have those. So if you have an uplight here, you might throw a Path and Garden light in here. You have an uplight here, you throw a Path and Garden light somewhere in here. You have your uplight here, and then so on and so on. And you can have a couple of those Path and Garden lights that help highlight the beds a little bit, but then it'll also work well with around the front of the house here. And what I would do with that same uplight, I would probably position one of those kind of right underneath the window here, again fairly close to it, that's shining more upright. And that's just a good rule of thumb anytime you're using accent lights, is you always almost want to shine them more upright than at the house. And by doing that, you get more subtleties in the, you know, the siding and all the little subtleties in the house. So I'd probably have one of those here, and then I would probably have two, one on each side of the window here. And then you could do that same theme, especially because you have the walkway here, with some Path and Garden lights, where I might throw one over in here. I might kind of throw one in here, one over in here, one kind of in front of the window, and then another one on that side. And would do a nice job of lighting the pathway, as well as staggering them kind of in between where you have those uplights and those accent lights. And then I would do the same thing over on this side of the house just to finish it off. I'd probably have one of those accent lights on both sides of the windows, that just kind of highlight the side of the house too. And then you have a really nice viewing angle all the way around the house, and not just in the very front. And then the last thing I would do is I would probably mount another one of those accent lights up here. And using that gutter mount picture that I showed you is actually quite easy. You can just run the wire either right inside or behind the downspout, run the wire across the gutter. All the connections are waterproof. Put the gutter mount, mount the light here, and again, have it shine more up to this peak. And then it kind of gets you this effect. And I think your porch is actually would look better because you have the railings and everything too that are going to catch some of the light. And it's really well designed for the Path and Garden lighting kind of combo with the uplights, because here you can see even as they lit up the columns, it's kind of darker in the middle here, and that's where having those path and garden lights kind of staggered in between would have been a nice addition, just to kind of help fill that that darker void. So hopefully that gives you a pretty good idea. I mean, you can always go on our website, just play around adding those different lights to your cart. We can always customize kits for you too. You'd probably be pretty close to fitting into one of our kind of packages too, where then you could just add a couple additional lights if you need to, but more than happy to help customize anything for you as well. So let me know if you have any questions and we can go from there.
So we are using a couple path lights on this project. One area we're going to use them is just to kind of create some balance in between. We're lighting up some of the architectural stone pillars on the front of the house, and then in between we're throwing a couple path lights from place to place, just so as you're looking at it from the street or the sidewalk, there's a nice balance of light between the uplights on the pillars and then some of the garden lighting that's going to be down below. So that's primarily where we're going to be using path lights in this area. And as always, we try and use as few as possible unless it makes sense. And in this case, we've got about 6 to 8 path lights that are just going to create a nice balance of light throughout this property. Hey guys, I really hope you enjoyed that video presentation with some great tips and tools on how to go and properly and effectively light up your landscape. And be sure, if you want your own free consultation video, just send me an email at cal@lightingdoctor.ca with a few pictures of your property, and we'll get back to you with some really cool ideas and ways to go and effectively light your property. And be sure to watch the videos after this one for more tips on how to install landscape lighting, as well as how to light up your landscape the best way possible.